Oh man, the number of times I've seen people wish they knew how to emergency stop their drone after they've been in one of these emergency situations. In this video, I'm sharing with you how to do it and when you might want to know how to do this coming up. Okay, all right. And if you're new here, yo, I'm Christine Lozada, and this is Drone with CL. I love helping people to explore the world from the best view in the house, which is the sky, with their drones. So if you're looking for more drone tutorials, consider subscribing. Let's start with how it works to emergency shut off your drone, and there are two ways to do this. The first way is by turtling your drone. In other words, flipping it completely upside down. And when you do this, it will shut off the propellers immediately. So let's give you a quick demonstration of what this looks like.
So I'm about to bring my drone over to me. I'll spare you the sound of my drone. But when I do, one of the key things about it is pinching the middle of your drone. Too many people try to grab it from the top. I know, I actually do have a lot of stories of people telling me they've done this. But when you pinch it in the middle, you wanna pinch it hard and make sure that your entire body is out of the way as you flip it over so that those propellers are not touching you. Feel like it's kind of like a high five, you know? You like, elbows high, look at the elbow. Let me bring my drone over. It's gonna get a little bit loud over here for just a minute. Make sure I'm in frame. All right, so I got my drone over here. I'm gonna pinch the bottom and then I'm gonna flip it over. So I'm gonna pinch and flip. And you can see it kind of fought me for a second, right? Like the drone almost kind of went up a little bit and I'm trying to keep it away from my face and away from my body. Let's try that again one more time. All right, round two coming at you. All right, let's bring my drone in. Oh, it's a gorgeous day. Come on over here, buddy. Yeah, yeah. All right, got my drone in sight. Pinch the bottom, flip it over. I'm gonna pinch it, flip it over. Boom, super fast, right? Confidently pinching it, flipping it over. The second way of getting your drone to emergency turn off is by pulling your sticks down and together or down and out. And a lot of people think, oh my gosh, like what if I accidentally make this movement and it falls out of the sky? It's actually really difficult to make this happen. I've been trying to make it happen and it's very difficult, but let me show you what that looks like. Let's look at this together in the safety settings and you can see that my drone, excessive aircraft rollover from the last turtling, right? So I'm gonna go to the three dots. I'm gonna go to my three dots and underneath safety, you're gonna see an area that says advanced safety settings. And underneath your advanced safety settings, you're gonna see the second thing here that says emergency propeller stop. And so I was playing around with it. Your auto setting will be under emergency only. That's what it's normally set at. I've been playing with it with any time use with caution, which I guess if you're curious about what that looks like, I'll save it at the end and you can see what that looks like because I've been trying to get it to shut off while it's in the air. Anyway, we'll play with that in a minute. But these are the two ways that you can get your drone to shut off. All right, let's head inside and talk about when you might want to use this because I'm sweaty right now. Your girl's working hard for you. Which by the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, cheers that like button, consider subscribing, and tell me in the comments below if you've ever had to use this before. And this is part of my entire drone course. So tons of info on that in the description below. Let's talk about when you might use this. So there are three times that you might want to use this emergency stop. And the first one is the one that I see the most. And it's specifically when you are on a boat or in a kayak or on a stand-up paddleboard, etc. And these are instances in which the boat might be moving a bit, right? You might be like out in the ocean, it's wavy, or there's current, or there's wind that's pushing your drone around. And it's not easy to quickly be able to grab your drone and just land it. A lot of people will try to land it in the center of the boat, or will try to crash land it into the boat. This makes me really sad. What it's important to do is to try to hand catch your drone, but especially if there's current or it's moving, then instead of just hand catching it, you're hand catching it and flipping it and turtling it. But there's something that kills me. Too many people do this by reaching over the side of the boat. No, you want to catch it and emergency flip it inside the boat, especially if you're like me and you've just come up from a scuba dive or it's just, there's a lot going on and things are slippery around you. In case your hand slips, your foot slips, anything, you want your drone to slip out of your hands into the boat. So don't catch it over the water, catch it inside of the boat. Number two, the second time you might want to use this is if your controller has run out of batteries. So if you have never seen this happen before, if your controller completely runs out of batteries, I talked about this in my drone podcast with Scratch Your Mappa. I loved this couple. But what happens is your drone will just hover. It will just hover wherever it's at. And in this situation, you're hoping that you can actually reach your drone. Hopefully it's not 100 feet up, it's somewhere near you. But if your controller runs out of battery, your drone will just hover, and that's a great time to grab it out of the air and flip it over. In this last scenario, which actually is pretty common, because as people are learning to hand catch and hand land their drone, there's a couple things you might get wrong. And as you're freaking out because your drone is going to freak out, I'll give you some examples, you might wanna know how to flip your drone. And so an example would be, if you're hand catching your drone, sometimes it's really windy. When it's really windy, your drone might be moving around a little bit and it might be like, ah, like not easy to. What's important when you're hand catching your drone is that your hand or your pinch is staying extremely still so that your drone thinks it's the land and will actually land into your hand. And so if things are moving around with the wind and your hand is moving around, it might confuse your drone and it might be popping away from you. And depending on the situation you're in, you might want to just simply grab it and flip it. And so it's important in windy situations. The second time people mess up in hand landing their drone and you might want to flip it is you need to stay very still. I learned this the hard way, in which I was kind of walking, grabbed my drone to hand land it and kept walking before the propellers stopped completely. And what happens is your drone gets confused and it will be like, oh, wait a minute, did you want me to land or not? And then instead of it slowing down, so at first the propellers will start to slow down, but as I kept walking during my hand land, my drone was like, wait a minute, she don't want me to land. And so what it starts to do is speed back up so it can take off. And so my drone was fighting me and I'm trying to hold on to it and it's trying to take off. In that situation, yeah, I could have let it take off and then do it over again, but I was in a very tight space and I couldn't let it go again. And so in that situation, when your drone is hand landing and then all of a sudden the propellers might start speeding up, boom, flip it over, and then you're all set. And the last situation is, I mean, it's a piece of technology, right? So many people are like, oh, I'm fine, I have my cell phone. Your cell phone is great until you're in an area that's dead and there's no reception and it doesn't work or it's out of batteries, right? Your drone is no different. It's a piece of technology. We cannot expect this electronics thingy thing to work 100% of the time. We expect it to work 10,000% of the time. Sometimes it just acts weird. And in situations like that, boom, flip your drone, make sure to emergency turn it off, and then go on your merry way. All right, let's recap what we learned today. First, we learned how it works. The first way, turtling your drone. The second way, in your advanced safety settings, you can have it where when you pull the sticks down and together or down and out, then your drone will automatically shut off and you have your safety scenario in which it's in the emergency setting only, or it's any time. I recommend you just leave it in that emergency setting only. The second part of what we learned is when to use it. Situations like when you're on a boat, and make sure, don't forget, to always catch or flip your drone inside of the boat and not while leaning over. In situations in which your controller, not your drone, your controller has run out of batteries, that's a time in which your drone ain't gonna land until it's completely out of batteries and then will auto land. And so if it's in reach, then you're flipping it over. And the last time to use it is when you're hand landing your drone and something goes wrong, whether it's just your drone technology's being weird, there's crazy amounts of wind, or your drone is accidentally landing and then taking off again, you might want to emergency stop it. All right, let's try testing this down and together thing to try to get this thing to fall out of the air. Probably shouldn't do this with a new drone, right? Okay, so my settings right now, I have the emergency propeller stop anytime used with caution. So when I was trying this lazily inside the house, I didn't have enough room, so let's try it outside. To bring it close to the ground just in case, you know. I don't know, maybe that's enough. All right, let's try. Okay, down and together. Come on. Wait, we gotta do that again. We gotta do that again. That's kind of awesome. Ooh, I have a better idea. Let's put it back to emergency only and then try. So let's go to emergency propeller stop. Emergency only, these are your settings. Now let's go blast it and let's go try that again. All right, round two. Okay, so we got emergency stop only. Let's see what happens. I'm gonna kind of close the ground. Seems pretty good. All right, ready? Woo! Dang, that was kind of hard. All right. See how it like didn't do it immediately? Come on. Nice. So did you see what happened? So what happened that time was it did the whole like landing beep 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 thing. Oh, that was different. That wasn't what I expected. Cool. Now we know. Now you know how to turn it off that way. I hope you never have to use that. Boom. If you got some value out of this video, cheers that like button, consider subscribing and join us in the drone Facebook group. All my course info is in the description below. Tag me on social media. I'd love to see what you capture and if you flip your drone, and I'll see you in the next tutorial. Ciao.